Yo, Shireen. Okay. I don't know. I'm sure there's some good stuff in there. Then I want to find out what those 3 to 4 decent ones are. Yeah, I don't know. I'm not sure which one you're talking about. Hey, that's a good find. Yeah, sorry, I can't click it. This is Final Fantasy VII soundtrack. Placed into the game. I promise you, it is the old school Final Fantasy music. But yeah, I mean, it's crazy how things have changed music-wise. Uncle Bomb start, so not a bad idea for this one. It worked out. We got a bottle and we got the boots to start because we did Uncle. We have the boots, though. We're gonna check what the lumberjack is. Okay, just a heart piece. I completed 7 back a while ago, but I haven't played through it yet again on my Xbox One profile yet, which I do want to. Fair enough. Is it just the series in general, or is this an RPG thing, or... complain really yet, you? Blue mail's nice. Blue cane is nice. Blue flippers are nice.
Blue bombs. The key, the well of the blue stuff. Okay, what I've got to figure out is why is Rainmaker not announcing stuff on my channel? What did I not do? Because thank you for the host, Jess, but like I thought all I had to do was like log in. Yeah, I should ask Joe or, I don't know. I think Joe's got it working. I just don't for some reason. For some reason, when I logged into Rainmaker and enabled all the alerts, it did not enable them actually on the channel. Was I supposed to do something further and I just didn't know? Checks and Ice Rod Cave, I guess, as well. Hey, a sword. And a hammer. And ether. Yeah, I'm not sure how much I like this one, this music pack yet. It's cool, but I want to keep experimenting and seeing other ones, because there's a lot of really cool ones out there. And I don't even know if the sheet that I was using has all of them. If I had a glove, I could check the back of the sanctuary, but I can't do that yet. Unless there's a 300 rupee at Zora Ledge, we're not getting Zora item right now. But I need to check the ledge. Maybe we'll come back for that bottle eventually. But it's not worth the extra time right now. Why do Eastern when we got the glove? Simple as that. I always have a tough time deciding about this one, whether I go east or west, after doing Pipe Cave. Well, eastern or western north is really, the, I guess, the question. If I had the mirror, I could full clear swamp. What is the situation?
Red crystals at swamp, TR.
Wow.
Blue pendant at thieves.
So two pendants in Light World. Back of escape first. Why did I do that? You don't bonk that. I'm just not as adept at that dark room. I can get there, and I can do it. Just not greatly. That's a mental lapse. I could climb Death Mountain. But I think we'll do Village of Outcasts first. Thanks, Jazz, for the bit. Much appreciated. And I see that Jess now has a founder's badge, which means that that resub, that early resub, did convert. Cool. Sounds a pendant, but we're gonna go in. At least clear the front four. Worst case, we leave and go. I guess Death Mountain becomes the play. By the way, we're playing as Nature Link. In other words, nudist. Wow, we have found nothing in the front of Thieves. One out of the three items in the front of Thieves. We're gonna go to the back because we've just found nothing. Big fat nothing. So there's at least three items in the back. Although I'm surprised, Jess, that your bit badge is not one of the bit leaders. I thought you would have been one of the bit leaders at this point. I don't know how all these things work. Twitch is an odd place. I'm just hoping something comes out of this play, because this is a real risk of a play to make. But so far, the back's been even worse than or just as bad, if not worse than the front. Blind's just gonna have the compass, and it was only worth a pendant. So, no value at all in Thieves Town today. Jeez. Moments. Okay, I think my one big complaint is that track cuts way too early. And it's water. I'm being good. Didn't even have a soda today. There's one item.
I feel like we just saw that happen in Reese's stream. Thank you, Ray. Why are you confused? And thanks, Lilcash. Who knows? Maybe we're only gonna get one. Hey, the bow. That's cool. Now that we've got that, let's check this out. Oh, green pendant eastern. And red pendant Hera. Okay. No! If that were to happen, oof. Nice. Mirror is really good. Come on, how about Titan's Mask? I could have tried a bomb jump there. Okay, no fire source, so we can't. We might not be able to complete Hera, but we're gonna give it a shot. Hey! At this point, we could actually get all three pendants and try for a ped pull. Why is it whenever I try to do a seed before Joe streams on a Tuesday or a Thursday, I somehow always get ones that go a little longer? Or that have possibilities for that kind of shit? I feel like I have bad luck on Tuesdays or Thursdays in the afternoon. To see, please, Moldorm, have the second item. Yeah, that track just ends too quickly. Ooh, that's a spicy find. Further to the left, I think, on that move.
out the Cane of Samaria, we can't even go into Turtle Rock, but I'll be able to find out what the medallion situation is. And I might just open it up. And the mushroom. Yeah, we're trying something out different today, Sean. Let's see, where are you? Okay. So, Ray, the mitts allow me to lift heavier stuff. So, like, you see this rock that has this light greenish tone to it. There's one that has this darker color scheme to it, and that one is liftable with the Titan Smiths. Yeah, that too. But we have the items required to finish Swamp and Desert right now. So I'm hoping Swamp Palace kind of like gives me some clues. We're still without a fire source. If I had the fire rod, I could complete Eastern and then I could do a pedestal pull. Which, realistically, I might as well just, like, I'll clear Eastern, check the green pendant, and then when I go to clear Skull Woods later, depending on when go mode comes up, I might as well pull it. Still haven't checked the pyramid, I still haven't checked Catfish, I haven't checked Zora itself. I know what the Zora ledge is, just a red bottle, so not a big deal. But I am considering to get it when I go do the Zora check.
so. Clear desert, even. I need fire so badly right now. I need some kind of fire source. Fire rod and I could complete Eastern Pod Desert easy. Lamp and I could clear them also easily. Okay, at the current rate, there's at least one item on left side of swamp. I can't pass up two left side items. Not right now. Too much left. Like, I could make the ice play. Ice Palace is full clearable, but without the red cane, I really don't want to have to icebreaker, not be able to icebreaker Ice Palace. Shows how greedy I've gotten now about that dungeon. Part of it's just like how much I hate Ice Palace without Icebreaker. Even the Ice Palace bomb jump bothers me. Because I don't remember the last time we hit one really decently. But technically, we have the items to clear it. If we do the bomb jump.
where we go next really comes down to what's in here. Okay. I'm glad we went back for Left Side of Swamp. Yeah, it's just a little important. Red cane. I need it. I don't know if it's what I wanted. Yeah, that's my thought, is that it's definitely a gamble item that a lot of people would have skipped in a race setting. That's a time that you try to save yourself. Although with Diver Down and the fact that we had Hookshot so early, it's very possible that an opponent would have Diver Downed it on the first run through. I'm hoping Front of Desert has fire right now, because without a fire source, we're kind of like... we're kind of in a tough spot. Lampless Mire is not fun. Interesting. Yeah. This is dangerous. Huh.
So, we clicked the go mode button, because technically I'm in go mode. I don't like it. This is like bad go mode. This is like very bad go mode. This is the bare minimum. Not a very safe go mode, because as it stands right now, we would have to hit Torch Glitch and get quite good patterns in phase four and actually like execute probably some triples in phase four. I think to win that fight. So I think we need to start, we still need to check stuff. To make sure that we have, if I can get the lamp, then I'd say we're definitely go mode. Half magic would be nice. Tempered sword would be nice. I don't know. Hey, the silver arrows. That's a good find. Yeah, that helps. Master Sword Ganon is still bad. Like, that's still not a good fight. Getting him into phase four in that fight is just a pain. But I think no matter what comes up here, we just go straight to Cold Snare. Yeah. I'm gonna skip Ice Tea. We're gonna play as if Ice Tea doesn't matter. Which I think is the right move. We're gonna play as if this is go mode still. Or quasi go mode. I must say, I do like the boss music being in these. Bad cold stare. That was not a bad cold stare at all. Okay, so we left one item in ice. Watch be the lamp.
That would require me to actually play on a PlayStation. Is it? I thought it was. I'm waiting for it to come to Xbox because I figured it was timed exclusive at best. I know, Ray. Get into one and like really want to play it, I could sink so much time in. But it's definitely a mood thing. I'm just trying to find this lamp before I have to do Lampless Mire. Keys. Still no big key either.
Thank you. Well, that changes things.
Be in the back there, so there's no point. But yeah, finding the Tempered Sword really does change the end of this now. Tempered Sword, Silver Arrows. Poof. That was a good turtle room, especially for a dark turtle room, jeez. Yeah, if I'm in go mode, I agree with you. I've seen it enough from watching others that, like, if you're in go, if you are specifically in go mode, like, yeah, only check what's in the path. We lucked out in defining both silvers and tempered. First time I officially did a silverless fight, I think I had like butter. And it was a ladder race. And then the second time it ever happened was a mystery seed where I had expert item pool and had to learn how to do Master Sword Silverless with 8 hearts and green mail. We spent 2 hours fighting Ganon that day. Let's just say it was not a happy fight. Mm-hmm.
I think we did that fight for 2 hours and lost by those 2 hours. Because it was like a 2 or 3 crystal Ganon. Fast Ganon at that. And I never found the cape. My opponent found cape. Looks like we put it off for as long as we could. I'm gonna do one thing. We're gonna trade that bee for a potion. And actually, while I'm here, we're gonna grab the red potion on Zoralech. 2 bottles. I just wanna be safe, because while I can do a Lampless Mire Dark Room, it is still it's the hardest one for me. If I had Cape, I'd be a little bit more comfortable. Watch me lose by a couple minutes because of this, but who knows? I'd rather be. This is one of those things the more I do it, the more comfortable I'll get, and the less safety I'll need. So. Yep, if I can get past that first room with the Samaria block placed, I'm fine. But placing a Samaria block in the dark is just such a crapshoot with the shooter enemies. Here's the crazy thing. For all I know, the lamp is on the pedestal in this scene. It's actually possible. Because we cleared Thieves and Hera. And then Eastern. As long as the big key wasn't in the vanilla location, we could get light. We could have done Eastern. With that fire rod. Or we're gonna get a Godmire. That'd be nice.
Wow, it's a Godmire. Thing is, once you get past that first room, everything else is just, you have the visuals. There are visual clues in this room of to where you are. And I'll say that me not doing Mire right after clearing desert and getting the fire rod actually is going to save me time, because we got the silvers. What? How did you get hit by a silver arrow and not die? No! Shoot! You were supposed to die from that arrow. Got hit by a silver. Set a flurry of silver arrows and... One of the silvers didn't actually connect. Or, like, it looks like it hit the eye and then the eye lived. Hey, it gave me more practice in the Mire Darkroom. That's fun. Oh, See, that's how that fight's supposed to go. Trollrock GT finish. And we saved our blue potion and our red potion. For better or for worse. For some reason, just that one arrow shot did not have the silver glow to it, and it was stuck into an eye and wasn't killing a vitreous eye. So then I wasn't in line for a zero cycle, and then I got lightninged to death.
The TR Dark Room. I know it, but I just like to have it just in case. Can I just say that the Turtle Rock Dark Room is actually harder in Enemizer without a lamp? Even if the room itself is like no danger, lampless, it is actually terrifyingly bland of a room without the fire bars. Mm-hmm.
Laser bridge. Worst part is that, like, if I had gone to Death Mountain instead of Thieves and the front of Swamp, we could have been in go mode probably about 20 minutes earlier, too. Try next kill. Fairly textbook, at least. Probably could have been a little quicker, but I'll take it. Good double spin and a slash. Come on. Off to GT! Thank you.
number 10. That extra arrow refill actually would be pretty good for doing some of these gauntlet runs with some arrows. Or at least Lambo 2. I was a little concerned when I didn't have any extras. But now... not a bad idea. Well, we don't have powder, so we're not getting any revive there.
Cycle. I had a shot at a one if I didn't get hit by that shot there, but whatever. From anything. So, we're just gonna go for it. Thanks, Lakash. Hey, we hit double digits now for Mulder and Falls on Twitch. don't know if that was a double. Two hit, but... were they right on top of each other? Yeah, that first one was a single. No. Could have just gone with a death there, Olkesh. That would have been very appropriate. But I appreciate the Ganon. Yeah, we lost. Yep. That was it. Damn it. 2 minutes. 2 minute loss.
So, unfortunate. Unfortunate. I shouldn't have invested the extra time into Thieves Town or Hera.
Live and learn.
Back of Thieves Town as a pendant is a trap of a dungeon. Don't do it. Usually. But, okay. We're done. I'll see everybody later. Maybe I'll do another race tonight. We'll see. Until then, goodbye.